Now, in 2020, the Black Lives Matter movement really shed a light on the issue of police brutality. It started with the death of George Floyd in the U.S., but Canada has its own reputation when it comes to police brutality toward minorities. So how do we compare to the U.S. in these terms, and how do we move forward?
Well, I think it's important for us to recognize that there are injustices, that there are things that happen in Canadian society, and we cannot feel that we are, as Canadians, immune to what we see on the screens from the United States. I think the issue of police brutality, the very savage killing of George Floyd, which was instantly circulated through media around the world. I think that we've had instances in our own communities here in Canada, especially in our urban areas, not only in terms of police, Black community, but police, Indigenous communities, et cetera. So I don't think that we can hold our head and say that we are above the injustices that we see in the United States. How do we move forward? Again, with the understanding that we have to do better, with the understanding of the kind of society that we are all working so hard to build, that we want to recognize everyone in our society as a person of worth and dignity. We have to look at police procedures. We have to look at the call that went out to look at what could be criteria for policing and police work, and how we can ensure that as we police, as we do these social justice, as we go through the courts, as we look at incarceration patterns, and the things that happen with African Canadians and people who are caught in socioeconomic difficult situations and their relationship with law and order and what is called for in the society to make it a place where people are respected and people are not brutalized simply on the basis of their socioeconomic status or the fact that they are Black Canadians or Indigenous Canadians. We have work to do in this society.
And I really want to go back to a previous interview where you mentioned something that really stood out to me. You said, in order for us to improve the future, you have to learn from the past. So how can we do that here in Canada, ma'am? And what are some specific lessons that we can learn from?
Well, it's important for us to look at the past because it's the past that informs us as to what we need to do in the present to lead us for a better future. And so when we look at, and I keep talking about when I came to Canada in the 60s, there were so many things, injustices, and the things that were in the system, because we didn't have any laws around that. We didn't have any SIU or ways the police were investigating themselves. We didn't have laws around landlord relationships. We didn't have human rights code at the time. We have moved with a whole series of laws in this country, policy direction in this country, ways of doing things. We've done umpteen surveys and reports and recommendations. And so we need to ensure that we implement good practices, that we examine leadership and those who are making decisions that affect the lives of so many. We need to look at what and who are represented in the judicial processes. So we have before us a wide spectrum of things that we need to do to bring about the just and fair and inclusive Canada that we all want to see.